In this video, we introduce Continuous, a system for building accurate 3D models of an environment using consumer-level RGBD cameras. RGBD cameras get their name from the fact that they output images where each pixel stores both a color and the depth from the corresponding point in the scene to the camera. Although a variety of RGBD cameras exist on the market, they have recently become ubiquitous due to the release of the Microsoft Kinect. Here we see an example output from the Kinect where the top image provides the color data, and the bottom image shows the depth where the brighter pixels are further from the camera. In 2011, researchers at Imperial College London and Microsoft Research published the Kinect Fusion algorithm that combines state-of-the-art visual mapping techniques with the Microsoft Kinect. The significance of Kinect Fusion was that it was the first low-cost system to create real-time dense surface models of an unknown scene. Their solution relied on the massive parallelism provided by modern graphics processing units to construct a volumetric model of the environment. The model is used to track the motion of the camera, and the motion is then used to improve that model by fusing information provided by the depth map. Given Kinect Fusion's use of the GPU to compute the volumetric model, the scale of the environment model is limited by the available GPU memory. Areas of the world outside that volume are not modeled, and movement outside of that model can result in loss of camera tracking. Continuous builds on Kinect Fusion by enabling it to operate over extended scale environments. Our system permits full 6 degrees of freedom motion over the camera. Rather than fixing the location of the volumetric model in space, we allow it to move with the camera. As the volume moves, instead of shifting the values within the GPU memory, we implement a set of cyclical indices, moving the origin of the space relative to the volume. This approach dramatically reduces the load on the GPU and allows real-time operation. In this sequence, we show a number of visualizations of the technique in operation. In the sub-window, we see the original color image and the depth map captured from the camera. To the right of the color image, we see the output of Kinect Fusion, rendering the scene that corresponds to the current view. The cube to the left of the images represents the current location of the Kinect Fusion volume in space, where we can see the motion of the cube as the camera moves. In order to build a complete model of the environment, each time the volume is moved, we extract a point cloud of the surfaces in the region that is leaving the volume. We refer to these point clouds as cloud slices. Each cloud slice is read off the GPU into system memory, where a separate thread of execution incrementally constructs a triangular mesh representation of the environment. This occurs concurrently and does not affect the Kinect Fusion processing. Adding color to the cloud slices requires a different approach to Kinect Fusion. Since the points in the cloud slice may not appear in the current frame, direct texture mapping is not possible. Instead, we augment the volumetric model to fuse the color information in parallel to the depth fusion. Now, when a cloud slice is extracted, the color has been computed a priori. Here we see the final point cloud with each cloud slice stitched into the global representation. As we zoom in, the density of points is clearly visible. In total, the model consists of almost 256,000 points distributed across 57 cloud slices. The corresponding mesh model encodes the topology between points. For example, all points in the tabletop are part of the same surface. This representation has many advantages, including the fact that it preserves occlusion relationships between objects in the scene. RGBD cameras typically only operate indoors. However, in this sequence, we see how they can be used outdoors during nighttime. The sequence was captured from the passenger window of a car over an extended distance in a suburban housing estate. Although difficult to see in the color frame, objects such as cars and driveways are immediately apparent in the Kinect Fusion and Continuous views. Note that since color images are so dark in this sequence, we only render the geometry in the final model. To give a sense of the scale of the final model, here we start with a zoomed-in view of a car and then zoom out to include the complete mesh. In our final demonstration, we show how Continuous can be used to build a 3D color mesh model of a complete apartment. The sequence is captured using a handheld Kinect with full 6 degrees of freedom motion. As can be seen, this includes moving between multiple rooms and descending a staircase. The final point cloud contains 1.4 million individually colored points across 162 cloud slices, whereas the mesh model contains over 2.5 million triangles and is 93 megabytes in size. In spite of the scale of the model, fine geometric and texture details are maintained.